Tea is the third largest foreign exchange earner for Uganda after tourism and coffee. However, there is no policy framework that regulates the tea industry in Uganda. Julius Andrew Mwebesa, a tea farmer from Kabale district, says tea is green gold, but because of lack of regulation, farmers are always in dilemma due to poor farm gate prices and exploitation by the buyers.
We are facing problems like pricing. We are being given very low prices. Some we are being exploited by our buyers, given different prices for the same commodity, and a lot of irregularities. We also want to fight the problem of fake inputs like fertilizers and herbicides. Yeah, there are fertilizers we even apply, and the crop doesn't respond.
Innocent Kato, another tea farmer from Kabalole district, says that due to lack of regulation, middlemen have infiltrated the business, cutting off a direct connection between farmers and processors.
We think after formation of the association, we should be able to engage, cause an advocacy, so that we have same prices all over. Any farmer in the country should agree. Say this is the minimum price for a leaf, and these are the standards so that we benefit from this cash crop.
Grace Bilungi, another tea farmer, says that despite the fact that outgrowers contribute 68% of the green leaf, they are never recognized by the processors. She, however, says that unlike other crops, tea has potential to increase household income.
People, farmers in Uganda, to grow more tea so that we can have income generating to our children, so that we can take children to school.
Onesmus Masiko, the manager Mabo Tea Factory, says that although government has under the Operations Wealth Creation Program, which supplies free tea seedlings, productivity is still very low. Masiko says that in Uganda, a hectare of tea produces only 1,800 kilograms annually against the expected 4,000 kilograms on best practices. He said that Uganda's main challenge in the tea sector is lack of regulation, financing, and poor fertilizer application.
Some intervention has got to come, and this needs to come from government, to stop horizontal expansion and concentrate on utilizing what we have developed as a country. Promote construction of factories where there is a shortage of processing capacity. Promote access to fertilizer to promote yield. Promote organization of farmers and preach the gospel of quality production.
Alex Amanya, a player in the tea sector, has highlighted some of the things that the farmers want the tea policy to regulate.
We don't regulate what happens at the Mombasa tea auction. So what we are looking at in the tea policy is to probably create another auction center that could promote the tea brand.
Story by Roger Sunday for the news.